Both the Caucasian neighbors, Azerbaijan and Armenia, have started hostilities once again. Both the neighbors have confronted each other at the disputed territory of Nagorno-Karabakh. Azerbaijan army has conducted artillery shelling on Armenian positions, and Armenians have shot down two Azerbaijani Air Force's helicopters in return. The dispute between these two countries is as early as 1918, when the World War I was about to end and the Ottoman Empire was in a decline. Azerbaijan claims that Nagorno-Karabakh is a part of their country, and Armenia also claims the same. Armenia does so because 95% of Nagorno-Karabakh's population is comprised of ethnic Armenians. Armenia and Azerbaijan fought a war over this piece of land between 1918 and 1920. Taking advantage of the situation, Soviet Union came in and took over these two countries. To prevent further hostilities between these two countries, Soviet Union made Nagorno-Karabakh into a separate autonomous republic under them. However, this was a blunder by Joseph Stalin, who was the dictator of Soviet Union back in those days, as this move was going to lay siege for further hostilities between these two countries in future. Relations between Armenia and Azerbaijan remained quite peaceful under the Soviet Union. However, the state of peace was not long-lasting. As the Soviet Union's power started to decline in the late 80s, the relations started to sour again. Nagorno-Karabakh declared itself as an independent country in 1991 and formed the Republic of Artsakh. This Republic of Artsakh pushed a resolution to join Armenia. The declaration of independence of Republic of Artsakh was rejected both by Azerbaijan and USSR. Thus, a war broke out between Armenia and Azerbaijan over the control of this disputed land, and this war lasted between 1988 and 1994 and led to the death of over 3,000 people. In 1994, the newly formed Russian Federation had to mediate a ceasefire between the two warring neighbors to prevent further bloodshed in the region. In this ceasefire agreement, the areas around Nagorno-Karabakh were handed over to Armenia. However, Azerbaijan has still not accepted the ceasefire agreement and has violated the ceasefire agreement multiple times to regain control of Nagorno-Karabakh and the area surrounding it. Despite the lands being under de facto Armenian rule, Nagorno-Karabakh and the surrounding areas are recognized as Azerbaijani territory in the international community. What is happening today is a result of decades of conflict between these two countries. This conflict is becoming more and more complicated as foreign powers join in and choose their side. Turkey has joined the Azerbaijan side and has been providing them with constant air support. A military spokesperson from the Armenian side claimed that a Turkish F-16 shot down an Armenian Su-25. However, these claims have been refuted by the Turkey's Ministry of Defense. Also, there have been some reports in which that our favorite neighbors Pakistan has been sending militants to Azerbaijan to fight the Armenians, as if sending militants to Kashmir wasn't enough. Just the way Turkey is supporting Azerbaijan, France and Russia have expressed support for Armenia. Many speculate that this region could become the third proxy war zone between Russia and Turkey after Syria and Libya. India and many such responsible powers from the international community have asked both the sides to exercise restraint. In recent times, as India's relations grow sour with Turkey, this has brought India and Armenia closer. India has also sold an advanced radar system to Armenia to fight off Azerbaijan and Turkey's air force units. Compared to the previous instances of skirmishes and assaults on the border, this one is expected to last longer and cause more casualties. This is due to the involvement of foreign players in this conflict. An escalation into a full-blown war could lead to disruption of energy supply and an energy crisis in Europe as a large oil and gas pipeline passes through the war zone. This conflict has started a blame game between the two countries over who started the conflict. Azerbaijan and Turkey call Armenia an invader, and Armenia has accused Turkey and Azerbaijan of ethnic cleansing and genocide. In my opinion, both the countries should keep their differences aside and come to the negotiation table and talk it out. This complex border dispute can be solved through exchange of territories on either side. Also, both these countries should bear in mind that Turkey and Russia should be kept out of these negotiations, as both of these countries want to push their influence into this region. Both these countries do not mind starting a proxy war and disrupting the energy supply of Europe. The disruption of energy supply in Europe will lead to devastating economic impact on the rest of the continent. So it's good for both of the neighbors to exercise restraint and make peace as soon as possible. So this is it for today's edition of Opinion Matters. Until then, keep asking the right questions, keep searching the right answers. This is me, Pranay Manyar, from the 21st Talk, signing out. If you like our content, then please do subscribe to our channel, like our videos, and share it to your friends and family. We also post stories of domestic news and international news on our Instagram page. So if you want these updates, then please do follow our Instagram page. Thank you very much.